Hello.
We're back.
It's a me, Paper Mario. Paper. We're here.
Paper Mario. We're doing all cleanup. Those G's.
Yeah.
So this is gonna be our winter wrap up stream.
Sure. Is it praying just for winter to end? Is that the idea?
We're just taking care of little things, I guess.
Oh yeah, we're playing cleanup to get rid of some trouble center things and finally complete Danger Mario, among other things.
Danger Mario.
But mostly Trouble Center stuff, and what else have we got? We could, not ready for the Pit of 100 Trials, not that yet, but...
No, nowhere near being close to being done with that. You said the delay?
Yeah, I did.
Alright. I'm on a new schedule, so if I'm tired, that's why.
Also...
All night shifts.
I have a new toy that I'm testing today too.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, I downloaded a program that's called a soundboard.
Oh god, you downloaded a soundboard?
Yeah. That's... Well, I got a soundboard program.
Soundboard of who?
Not a soundboard that someone else made.
Okay.
Just a soundboard program. So that it's you not can
like
set an sounds
it's
to.
Not like the Arnold Schwarzenegger classics.
No. No, it's with our own sound. So now we have classics like. Oh, it's messing with Twitch. That's nice.
Oh, what happened?
It changed the it changed what was broadcasting.
Oh no.
Maybe it has to be up.
Probably. You downloaded a soundboard. Why am I not surprised?
Well, that was a less than thrilling reveal.
Yeah.
Maybe I have to start it with the TV plugged in order for it to go through the TV.
Perhaps. I love how it doesn't show half the fucking party members on the screen.
Yeah, well, you can't spoil them.
Well...
I guess they could have had, like, different screens.
Perhaps.
If they were going to,
Which one's our file? Is that one?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh yeah, that's right, we're Luigi now.
Ah, fuck it, it's not gonna work. I'll do it later.
Okay.
I'll try it again in a future stream.
Perhaps. We'll get it working next time.
With the TV. It works through the headphones. Yeah, we're Luigi now. And we just got the sixth star in weird dreamland place.
Yeah.
In a painting.
We hid the star in a painting. Oh, like Bowser. That's cool, I guess.
No, no. Ours you dig a pipe into. It's different and original. You found the real crystal star, Luigi. Let's-a-go.
Yeah, gotta fight my way out of Terminal 7. It's filled with zombies and shit. They just jumped out the fucking window.
Well, why can't I?
I remember that.
If they could do it.
Because that'd be rude.
Okay, I gotta use the front door like a civilized person.
Mario's not a dick. What's with that star panel?
That's where you jump to get to the
thing up there. Oh, that's right. Yeah, the spring jump. Okay. Well, that's the end of that. Let us continue.
With Bowser and Peach. Peach and Bowser.
Oh yeah, this is the one where Peach finally. I think maybe this is the one where the jig is up. Falling for. That's asinine. Love that word, asinine.
Jeff Foxworthy did a shtick on the definitions of words. It was like one of them was letter carrier. Well, if she's gonna pack all that, then shoot, let her carry her own luggage.
Oh. Oh, yeah, that's the fucking redneck.
Or asinine. Give her face a two and her asinine.
Oh, yeah, that's the How's the magician? Safari ain't doing so good.
Yeah. I didn't hear that one, but that was the redneck dictionary.
I'll have another.
What?
Because he's steadily getting drunker. It's becoming lava.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
and
I think that was
comes
the redneck
that goes, hey, he's about to spew like a volcano.
I think it was the redneck dictionary is what that was.
Yeah, that's the gag he uses, redneck dictionary. Here we go!
I did kind of like that in the previous game you could find items as Peach and send them to Mario.
Yeah, they don't do it in this game, though.
Nah.
Because it doesn't make any sense.
They realized the magic chest was stupid.
Hey, Tech, you can take this item and fire a rocket at Earth with it on there.
I have reached a conclusion.
You have.
I have struggled with whether to obey orders or speak to you, and I don't know what to believe.
I don't know what to believe anymore.
You don't understand.
Nobody understands.
Peach, please escape.
Peach, you must leave. Now.
I found out everything about the plan. Oh, okay, she gets to hear, but we don't.
According to the data, I thought Krunk was gonna burst in and go, what is this?
You mean Grotus?
Yes.
It'd be weird
if...
Well,
one of the two!
If Krunk broke in... How do you get here so fast?
I knew you were up to no good, Tech.
I will tell you exactly where you are.
This is
the moon!
We're on the moon! We're on a moon base. Moon base Alpha.
This is Major Tom to Ground Control.
No.
Let me sing you a song I learned, Peach.
Peach. Peach. I'm human. I'm alive.
Have you heard this, the space oddity in Moonbase Alpha?
I have not.
That was a whole video.
Oh, that's great.
That someone did like a fully orchestrated version of a space oddity with the guitar and everything,
and
sung by Moonbase Alpha.
The text to speech.
Yeah.
The best one.
Not just one voice, a chorus of them.
Nice. Oh no! Hold it. Stop right there.
You!
The epic theme of Lord Grotus.
Sounds like the Blue Man Group smashing a... Oh, never mind. There's Evil Guy music.
Sorry. It just needed to kick in.
Yeah. It sounded like the Blue Man Group just smashing on, like, xylophone trash lids at first.
Yeah. I love it when somebody sees somebody doing something like betrayal and the other guy just laughs and I'm like,
I am normal. There is no malfunction.
I'm alive!
So this is basically the,
Johnny Five for evil people.
No, this is basically the Amy and Gamma story all over again, right?
Yeah. Except with less, like, except Gamma was badass and he killed everybody else.
He said, I love you, in text, as he died.
No, you killed...
Tech is no longer with us.
Yeah, he's uploaded to a satellite before it crashed down. He's with all the other Tachikomas.
We've overwritten his OS with Windows 3.1.
You feed! Oh, wait. Windows... So there's still some of them left because Windows 3.1 is small as shit.
He's just going to be like GLaDOS operating on the potato power. Peach, where am I?
That was the funniest part of that. Just, oh, how are you? You know, I'm okay. Because I'm a potato!
You did this to me!
Meanwhile...
Wow, he's playing Danger Bowser.
Even the people in Roadport are afraid of Bowser.
He's playing Danger Bowser.
Yeah. I got nothing!
Mario's gonna steal everything from me. Again! The fiend!
Hey!
We did it! The Magic Koopa scouts found a suspicious underground chamber! Really suspicious!
Oh.
Welcome to my laboratory!
Oh god. Wow, you look interesting enough to be experimented on. Let's do it.
Reinforced? Fuck it, I'm Bowser. I can take it.
It's a goal.
Whatever.
Not my business.
I was gonna...
He's got a chestnut king to beat.
Yeah. Or whatever is going on with that storyline. Oh.
I think that's the bad guy he's supposed to be against. Which is weird because Goombas are based on chestnuts.
So he's fighting the Goomba King.
Yeah. So you think the Chestnut King has like Koopas are his weakest enemies? He's got like little shitty turtles working for him.
Oh my god, that'd be great. Weird ass alternate universe.
Wait.
Up is down and black is white. Is that a wise idea? I guess so!
Just in time for the level. These are too short. These levels need to be longer.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
I'm sure nothing bad will happen.
Oh, there was a dude in there. Bye.
You did it! Congrats! Oh, he's still too big!
And then he ducks and turns around.
Stuck. I'm stuck.
Kind of petered out, Mario Maker.
Yeah. Oh, it's a gym!
Nothing stood in your way.
So where are we?
I felt right at home going through that castle.
Look! Lord Bowser on the wall behind you! It's...
a crystal star!
Oh! Wait! He's back in fucking Glitzbit!
For the third time!
How the fuck did you go underground and end up in the sky?
That's no sense of direction!
That's impressive! Alright.
You forget these muscles?
No.
You cleared my secret training facility. I even imported some super freaks to up the difficulty level. Oh, no one remembers that song. Everyone just remembers Hammer Time.
So Kata versus Bad Luck falling all over again. Oh wait, that didn't happen yet. Oh yeah! Oh!
Ow.
That's what you get.
Could a weakling do this? Splat. I like how even though Bowser is the joke villain in this game, he's still competent enough to trash everyone but Mario.
Yeah, it's like how everybody forgets Yamcha can actually kick your ass.
Yeah. Or Yajirobe for that matter.
Yeah.
Yajirobe was more helpful throughout Dragon Ball Z than Yamcha ever was.
Yeah, Yamcha can still kick any normal person's ass.
Yeah.
He's also a world star baseball player.
Yeah.
Yamcha, the most normal of the group.
Stop speaking in riddles, you chicken nugget!
Oh no, it's gonna blow a gasket. Alright, so that's that over with. Let's go do our pre-moon base shit.
I guess we could do, if we run out of, like, Trouble Center stuff, we could also do, like, the stuff up to the actual start of the chapter.
Yeah, and then just get in the chapter.
Well, we start the actual moon part next time, I mean.
Yeah. It's Princess Peach, she's got information.
Mario, what do you mean? I'm Luigi.
Alright. I'm in disguise!
I know where I'm being held.
I'm on the moon!
Yes, Snake, the moon. The moon that floats out in space.
It's all Metal Gear Solid, except it's in space.
In order to resurrect the monster spirit, they need my freakish anime knowledge. Help me, Snake!
Snake! Oh, hey! Hey, brother, I have a dead ringer for you!
What's going on there, Mario?
No, I'm not Mario, I'm Luigi. What are you talking about?
No reaction, huh? Yeah, you wear whatever you want, Mario, it's up to you.
Man, his partner is sad.
It's like a little crying onion ghost. That's Luigi's pal, Screamy.
Oh.
Screamy creeps me out. I've never seen anyone like that. Where's he from?
Where are you from?
So that the last chapter was Luigi's spook chapter. That was his Twilight Town.
And then he encountered like a crazy old dude who speaks in riddles.
Yeah, sure. Apparently, there are more of those sprites in the game's coding. Like, they were going to be an enemy somewhere.
But they decided, nah.
Just turned out they decided to be better if it was just screamy there.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Luigi gets one over us.
What do you got? Oh, I'm short.
About how many coins?
A lot.
What was that one?
That was the W emblem. The Wario?
Oh, damn it! Then we gonna. Oh man, we could've used that. Oh well. We'll just have to settle for that chest.
We haven't been Luigi long enough anyway. Oh wow.
So we just left that lying in plain sight.
Yep.
It's great.
I had to look up to find out that was something that was where you got that. Because I always thought that was just a water tower. You can't see the top of it, so you can't tell it's a chest.
Yeah, somebody... Congratulations, the town's water supply has been contaminated.
You get a new hammer technique. It's exactly the same as the old technique, but we're going to make you do it again anyway.
You know, I hate it when be like... Get those assholes that are like, I'm gonna fucking bathe in the water tower.
Yeah. You can even break stone blocks.
Suppose of those other blocks made out of not stone.
This is kind of sad. This is the last time I'll get to see you.
Oh, it's fine. She looks like she's heartbroken.
Toadette.
Fuck.
Toadette for Artificial Academy.
No. Because they don't have genders.
No. That's the canon, apparently.
It's still so weird. It's like, dude, why? You can't just backtrack on that.
These two are the same. Yes, sir.
We're all the same. But how do you reproduce? Spores.
You think Goombas don't have genders either?
I don't know, because a Goombella is like, kind of a straight up example of
like physiologically.
Like nobody has genders, but they all got gender.
Yeah,
identities.
They just reproduce by budding.
But they all got gender identities.
Right.
It's weird. Welcome. I guess that's like the Tumblr's ideal future.
Yeah.
It's like everybody.
Oh boy, we can get purple attack sounds.
Attack sounds!
My attack sounds like purple. I want to save up for Wario first, though. You know what? We'll have some coins after some Trouble Center stuff.
Alright. We will solve the troubles.
Can I just say again how much I miss the spin dash, though?
Make the game quicker.
Yeah.
Just, I'm gonna dash this way now.
It's like Legend of Zelda without the ability to roll.
Oh, you mean the original Legend of Zelda?
Yeah, not the 2D ones. Well, no, I mean, yeah. I see what you're saying.
I got you there.
Let's go Bobbery.
Okay. Yeah, because he can actually, like, do sneak attacks really well.
Shazubi! I like how Merlin and the fairy godmother were basically an item in Kingdom Hearts.
This is really great. Oh, we're both magic, right? We should date.
We're both old magic people.
Functionally immortal. Yeah, we can do it.
How many other old magic people are there that aren't villains? What, you want me to date Rasputin?
Only Yin Sid, and that's about it.
He's a serious dude. She tried dating Yin Sid first, then went to jolly old Merlin.
Merlin knows how to party.
Wasn't Yen Sid like a summon?
No, he was like an actual character in 2.
In
2, like,
right.
He's like, they're like, hey, sorry, you should go talk to Yen Sid. He's pretty cool. He'll give you some new clothing. And he's like, yeah, this new clothing allows you to dual wield keyblades.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I remember what we can,
We gotta play Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah, we do.
And I have the PS3 remix version, so we can totally play that.
Oh, okay.
Kingdom Hearts 1.5 HD remix.
We can,
which is basically Final Mix. Yeah, sorry, go on.
We can go back to, you know where. And do some, fighting.
Oh,
That'll take a while, though.
Wait, where? I don't know where. Where?
The Glitz Pit.
Oh, yeah. Wait, can we do that again?
Goomfrey, in front of Frankly's place. Try not to be seen.
Seen by who? The cops? What cops?
Am I transporting heroin?
I don't know. What's an illegal substance in the Mario universe? Like, what's explicitly forbidden?
I feel like there was, like a drug story at some point. This is in the right place.
A drug story?
Or, like, something that, I mean, we... I guess Chocola Cola is like alcohol.
Oh, Caracola.
Front of... I keep passing it. Front of Frankly's, okay.
I mean, considering, Japan's, like, okayness with alcohol versus America's, like, we can't allow children to know it exists yet.
I'll dispose mentality of this in a way no one will ever find it.
It explains why there's a place called a juice bar in Super Mario RPG.
Yeah, there's one here, too.
Yeah. Probably alcohol. All right. You guys, 20 coins!
This salty old sailor following me around as I do drug deals.
he's your muscle.
Yeah.
If somebody tries to, like, renege on a deal, you can just have him explode all over people.
Yeah. Like, normal in our world, someone would pull a gun on them. In our world, we pull out bobbery.
Reminds me of, like, a scene in Knights of the Old Republic where, like, a guy was trying to shake down two other, like, alien dudes. He's like, you owe us some cash. He's like, they're like, no, we're not paying. Fuck you. And he's like, oh, really? Well, I got this guy. He brings up this big muscular dude with, like, this giant fucking gun. And then they're like, nah, never mind, we'll pay.
Yeah. I'm opening up a shop. I need the price of Fireflower, Sleepy Sheep, and Tasty Tonics.
What?
In Rogueport. So that I know how to set my prices.
Oh, so... Can you lie to him?
No, not you! Oh, dear.
Yeah, that's a lot faster.
Lots of footwork going on. Where is he? He's in front of the store, I think. There he is. No?
The rat?
It's not the rat, he's got a different job.
Oh, somebody defrauded him over a fake credit card?
Marioverse has credit cards?
They got POS systems? That would imply that somewhere in Rogueport is a bank.
Yeah.
Maybe the Mafia run it.
Well, I mean, they do have the gold bar system.
Yeah, I guess there is, like, a gold standard in,
Oh, is this guy outside Yes, I totally did. Fireflowers are 90 coins. Sleepy Sheep are 8 coins.
What are you?
Tasty Tonic is 198 coins.
What?
That's rough, buddy.
Those are some low prices. 190 coins! Wow, that's dirt cheap!
Here's your reward!
So you actually lied to him. What did that change?
Nothing.
So he doesn't ever open up a shop?
Nope. My name's Goomther. Please find the guy that pulled off credit cards on me.
Alright! Foreshadowing. Successfully coming full circle.
I need to solve my identity theft.
Somebody committed identity theft on me, Mario. You know what that's like, right?
We're going around giving Luigi a good no. Identity theft, huh? That's rough, buddy. Yeah. I, Luigi, wouldn't know a thing about that.
By the way, Mario, why are you parading around as Luigi?
Forget about it.
hey, God, he's committing identity theft right in front of me. You seem like you'd be the right person to solve my identity theft problem.
Hey, guy in a red jacket and blonde hair, can you help protect me from this guy in a red jacket and blonde hair?
Oh, God!
Dumbest character in Trigun.
No, this is different because it's not like... Oh, God! Mario's like... How many... It's like, also, he pretends to be Bowser on the side.
I think I should roleplay as the princess. A lot of people are into that.
It's just a fat Italian dude in a dress. Just like, I'm Princess Peach now!
I think that was, yeah, that was one of the options you could give the buzzard in Paper Mario 1. I'm Princess Peach! You wanna fight about it?
So you live... Oh, you didn't steal the credit card? Oh, my mistake.
He said it's a bandit, so we're literally just profiling. Checking out all the bandits in town. It can't be easy when your species name is literally bandit.
Yeah, well...
People gotta assume the worst about you.
Maybe it's like the pronunciation is similar to bandit, like it's...
Bandit.
It's got like a comma somewhere. And then they spell, oh, you know that bandit.
Yeah.
We prefer Bandito, we prefer Bandito, sir. Does it come from the country of Bandito? Yeah, Bandit.
A different dude. Where'd he go? He's back here, I bet. In a shady alley. No?
Gotta investigate Shady Shin. Just a guy called Shady fucking Shin.
Gonna go ahead and rob you and leave.
So cops, which means there's no such thing as Miranda rights. You can get away with anything because we're fucking we are authority.
Yeah.
Like Judge Dredd, I am the law.
Mario, basically the cop.
Cripes! The fraud police. We'll throw you in ISO cubes if you don't comply.
Walks through town. Hello, Jody. Now he's in the alley? There he is. Hanging with us is buddy, the other bandit, Bandito. Fine, do with me as you will.
Just give him back his fucking credit card.
Here's your reward.
20 coins.
You might not want to watch this, Luigi.
Oh no. Gangland Justice. He's death marching him! He's gonna death march him outside of town, shoot him in the gut, leave him for the birds.
Not my problem.
Your guts are gonna fill with shit, and you're gonna die slowly and in agony.
There's so much shit that happens in this town that's just not Mario's problem.
It's like fucking Mabel going to the bar and seeing that unconscious dude. He's resting.
Just looking out for number one.
Well, that's over with.
Hit me!
Oh, okay.
This one gets... This one's
oh,
a
no,
really...
this one sucks.
This is the worst reward in the game.
Because it's all luck-based.
Eh, well, I meant the reward you get from it, but we'll get it done. It won't take any time. You accepted my trouble. I smell it.
You smell like the trouble center. It's like...
Yo, use B! Yeah.
Oh, you can't just mash it because then if he remembers, you'll hit him again and then he...
Well, you also can't do it immediately. Oh, yeah, you can, I guess. There's like a...
There you go.
I had to buy a sleepy sheet and sell it for a 2-coin profit in Petalburg. I'll let that tip be your reward.
Yeah, I guess you have enough patience, you can have infinite money, but...
Who's got patience?
Fuck that. We're on a timetable. They buy Sleepy Sheep 2-coin profit over at Petalburg.
Be the worst fucking way to make money. I'm hungry.
Well, a long enough timeline is actually the best way, because you just run an import-export business.
Well, yeah, but you can just, like, kill enemies and get money way faster.
Yeah, the piracy route. I'm sure that's what a lot of, like, sailors were thinking. It's like, why are we making so little money just selling goods over here when I could just go and fucking raid, like, treasure ships?
Hello, Belosi.
Hello. Oh, Belosi!
Yeah.
Yeah, we haven't seen him in a while. Hello!
Yeah, I saw him on the Awesome Knots forum.
I know he's doing
recently.
Awesome. He's doing Awesome Knots again. That's cool.
No, I don't know if he's streaming or not.
Oh, he's playing Awesome Knots at least.
Yeah.
Wait, it's the ghost ship.
Is this him? Oh, right. My wife brought my lunchbox, but it was empty. Bring me something to eat. Anything.
Oh, so either somebody ate his food, or his wife just gave him an empty lunchbox? The fuck does that mean?
Tasty, tasty dry shrooms. That hit the spot.
Yeah, it's like beef jerky. Oh, it gave you 11 coins.
Oh, I think the amount of coins you get is relevant to the item you give him.
Oh, man, you could have gotten more.
Yeah, whatever. So it's basically just an opportunity to sell something a little higher than normal. I gotta get the W emblem. Why do you gotta be here now?
We need a lot more coins.
I think you can give him a maximum of 500. Maybe. No, it's less than that.
We don't have enough money. We need more money. Mayor Croup.
Will someone please come talk to me? Pretty please?
He just wants somebody to talk to him.
I'm lonely.
The saddest trouble centered request.
Alright, we got Ultra Hammer. We can smash blocks now. What do we got? How many star pieces do we have? Is there anything we're getting? Probably checked last time.
I guess a badge. You can be pretty lucky.
Eh.
Save the flowers. Okay. Oh wait, no, you can't.
Also, while we're here. Wait for me. Ah.
Nope, you gotta wait for the elevator. Oh, hey, a pipe. Now it's a
parkour!
Roof jump.
Oh, hey, you want to go all the way back to the Pirate Cove to get that one shine sprite that was hovering too high to reach?
God damn it. I guess at some point we gotta do that, but...
Not now, though.
No.
Where are we going? We're going to Petalburg.
We'll forget about that, then we'll wonder. We're one shine sprite off from leveling up our final party member. Who are we missing?
I remember that. There's also one in Glitzville that's slightly too high to jump to.
Oh, that one. Fuck.
But that's a lot easier to get to than the Pirate Cove one.
Yeah, I guess so.
I guess. Here we go.
Alright. The most peaceful town to ever exist.
He's gonna walk straight by Koops' friends. Visit him? Nah. He doesn't miss him.
They don't recognize you. You're obviously not Mario.
Yeah, I'm Luigi.
Murphy!
I'm not Murphy. I'm Luigi.
I'm Loogie.
I'm Loogie. Yeah.
Just going on about youngsters these days.
Stealing Cranky Kong's gimmick.
Hey, you punks! Be more patient! There we go.
Forgot to set up my tea.
I haven't even added the hot water part. I'm sorry.
Oh, he gave you a leaf.
Yeah. So from now on, if we come talk to him anytime, he'll give us a leaf.
Which does... something, I guess.
It's a cooking ingredient.
Oh. Oh, it's like seasoning?
Well, you can make tea out of it, among other things.
Ah. Mario tea time.
Go ahead and take care of this. Ooh, there's a badge.
I guess there's no way to get to it before. FP plus. That's pretty good. This. Gotta redo the spot, bro. You got it!
And one more. And now we have island access and poshly access.
Poshly. Go to poshly's. Just getting some guys. It's like, you lower the tone. Get the fuck out of here. We've gentrified this area. Your kind isn't welcome.
Filthy poor person. What are you talking about? I'm Luigi.
I'm the richest.
I could own you. I could own this town.
God damn. You know, if you were to pull off an identity theft on anybody, it would be Luigi. Cause you know what's weird is that Mario's Adventures, he like gets like 100 coins is a lot. 100 coins can buy him an extra life, and then you play fucking Luigi's Mansion. He's making like 10k like in the first part of the level.
Luigi will never die.
Luigi owns a fucking mansion. What does Mario got?
A shack.
That Luigi just kind of stops by it and like watches occasionally in case he wants to get out of like the big city.
I guess we do see Mario and Luigi's house in this game, like in the intro, but I'm sure Luigi was just visiting.
Yeah, I got a mansion now, Mario. Pretty sweet.
What were we? Okay, we solved the trouble. The main one we need to get to is there's a Frankie and Francesca one that will unlock the item we need in the parlor, the casino.
Ah. Oh, that'll be good. All right. I guess. Okay.
Six more.
I just realized, like, more games should have ninja characters.
Like as party members or just in general?
Yeah, you know what would be cool if there was, like, a Paper Mario game with, like, a ninja as a party member? Like those little ninja cats?
I think that fan Paper Mario game does have one.
Nice. I'm glad. Oh, you're talking about Epic Paper Mario?
I think, was that what it was called?
I guess, yeah. Which means I gotta retitle my fucking fanfic.
I thought that was Epic Mario.
Yeah, but that's being used for something else, and that'll be confusing.
Okay, come to the shop in Rogueport Square. I think he needs, like, courage shells.
Alright. That whole lot of combat going on.
Who watches this game for combat? Combat system sucks.
Apparently Nintendo thought so.
Okay, 5 courage shells.
So he needs to get restocked, is that it? Oh, hey! Luigi came out with his novel.
Yeah. You want to spend coins on those?
Oh, well, I would, but I got more important things to buy.
Why doesn't Mario have a novel? Because he can't afford to pay someone to write it. That's a thing people are doing now. They're getting people to write novels, and then other authors put their names on them as endorsements.
like how you had Sin City and Quentin Tarantino wasn't involved, but they're like, hey, slap his name on it so the movie will sell.
Yes, exactly like
God
that.
God damn it.
Like you'll see a book at the bookstore with Stephen King in big bold letters on it. and then underneath it in little tiny writing, written by such and such.
Written by John Woo.
So it's basically just endorsed by Stephen King or whoever the fuck they're getting.
God damn it! Like...
Because names sell.
People, research indicates that people are so stupid, they can only... They'll buy whatever has, like, an author's famous author's name on it.
Yeah, well, because they don't read. It's like, they're buying books, but they don't read.
Stephen King presents 50 Shades of Grey.
I don't know. I don't know if I should put my name on this one.
No, he didn't. Imagine if he did. Like,
what's the sequel called? 50 Shades Darker?
Yeah, and then 50 Shades Freed.
Oh, there's another one.
Yeah, there's a trilogy.
Oh.
God damn it. Like, the Twilight fandom is weird.
Yeah.
Like, you had the fucking actor who played Edward Cullen, like, afraid for his life from that role. And I just felt bad for the guy, like, he's gonna be mobbed by fangirls for the rest of his life.
Oh.
Like, I mean, in and of itself, that can't be bad. Having fans isn't really a bad thing, but they're, like, running up to him. He's like, suck my blood, Edward Cullen! And he's like, no. Who's on record as calling the author of Twilight a fucking lunatic? On record! He doesn't give a fuck!
I'm sure the author of Twilight doesn't give a fuck either, because she's making all the money. It's a she, isn't it?
Yeah, it's she. If a man wrote Twilight, I would be extremely confused.
Yeah.
Because traditionally, I've noticed a trend, like, I don't think male-written romance, like,
I can't think of much.
There's
not a lot of successful male-written romance, I don't think.
One example of male-written romance I can think of is this visual novel called this, like, The Song of Seiya.
Yeah.
And it's like this, like, it's about this guy who, like, woke up with, he got, like, brain damage, and he woke up and he saw everything was, like, gore covered and, like, everything red and shit, except for this one woman. And he's like, and he decided to make this woman, like, his reason for living.
Yeah.
And then things get really fucking horrible. Did I mention that the guy who wrote this is also did Madoka Magica?
Did it turn out she was a yandere?
It turned out she was an eldritch abomination.
Oh, okay.
And, like...
Well, beauty's in the eye of the beholder.
Yeah, and then,
even if your girlfriend is a beholder.
Yeah. And like, there's a scene in which they partake in cannibalism.
Okay.
Cause fuck it.
Was Madoka Magica a manga before it was animated?
No. It was... I don't believe so. 2, 3...
Yeah, just don't take them all at once. Make me do the tedium. That's 5. You're done.
It's our reward.
Oh, Ultra Shroom. That's nice. You actually can't buy those anywhere. So, actually, no, there is a shop, but they're real expensive, so...
Hmm.
I'll just store that for later.
Ultra Shroom, a.k.a. a life of Shroom. Such powerful medicine, it's able to kickstart someone's heart. It's like that fucking scene in Pulp Fiction where the guy is stabbing the syringe in her chest.
You think there's such a thing as overdosing in Mario? Like, if you had 5 hit points and you took an Ultra Shroom?
This is... This is Mario just lying on a couch. Slight vomit just going down, like, this corner of his mouth. His eyes just glazed over and Peach comes and is like, OH SHIT!
There's a reason it's called Danger Mario.
Dawsworth, he's fucking dying on me, man! Well, Peach, you should bite the bullet and just go to the hospital and deal with the cops. Not a chance, I'm coming over!
I want me some life insurance, a life shroom. I'm in no big hurry, but sometime before I die would be nice. Do I have a life shroom?
Turns out he got Hitman on his tail. He's, like, needing it to, like, his, like, you know, backup.
I gotta check my storage. I can't remember where I can buy a life shroom. That's not the right place. That talk about male-female authors reminded me of that, remember that Powerpuff Z episode with the guy who wanted to draw shoujo?
Oh, yeah.
His characters were all ultra buff and JoJo-ish.
And then the girls were like, hey, why don't you just draw shonen, man?
That's brilliant!
Yeah. Fucking drew the Powerpuff girls as, like, fucking,
JoJo characters.
That's a series we gotta watch, by the way.
Oh, yeah, it's on our list.
It's dubbed, we got no reason not to.
We'll be looking at the 2012 version.
That's apparently still going on.
Is it?
I guess. I don't know if it's
I wouldn't be surprised. I wonder who's dubbing it. I guess it's not on... I probably haven't heard of it because it's not on Adult Swim. Surprisingly, you'd think they would dig into that.
Yeah. JoJo's probably too weird for them.
Do you listen to yourself?
Hey, I to be fair, I guess they did bo, so...
On Toonami, yeah.
Yeah.
I had a weird dream last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's a good sign. What'd you have a dream about?
What I remember started with being it, It was like a family get-together, but I knew it, I somehow knew that it was the Arizona State Fair.
Okay.
And for some reason, a bunch of my family was there, and I texted Road Rocket like, yo, I'm at the Arizona State Fair, where you at?
that actually makes sense, because you mentioned that, like, your family bought a whole bunch of property in Arizona.
Some of them did. But we're nowhere near it. And,
celebrating Arizona State Fair in Washington.
And, it was also... Either in the building or it turned into the building that was the William Street offices circa, like, 2000.
Oh my gosh.
So the Toonami building.
The Toonami building.
And the event basically got raided by a new version of Tom.
Oh gosh.
It was like an evil Tom taking the building back from us filthy partygoers or whatever.
It was an attack on Toonami.
Yeah. And it was like a video game plot with Tom as the bad guy.
Oh man, that sounds exciting.
And then at some point things petered out, and I think the threat of Tom became less of an issue because we found out a giant flood was coming.
Oh, that's not good. A flood in Arizona!
So we had to, we had to prepare for that.
A flood in Arizona.
And there was a sad conflict about what Granny Xelrog was going to do because she obviously couldn't swim when the flood came.
A flood in Arizona.
Yeah. And the flood did come.
Oh, God. Did you get your ark built to every animal?
Well, we'd collected all the floating stuff in the building.
Okay.
Which included a lot of, like, strips of insulation that floated for some reason.
Alright.
And, me and my dad were there, and we teamed up and grabbed some of those to float on.
Oh, that's good. How'd you survive?
Where the hell are life shrooms?
Don't you have one in storage?
No, I checked.
Oh, man. You might not be able to do this. No, I don't. I didn't think this would be a problem.
Maybe in the great boggly tree?
Where's a life shroom? Let's go find one.
Anyway, my dad and I were floating off, and I think we got separated. And I was just kind of floating by myself, and I realized, okay, I'm floating across this giant sea of flood, and there's only one logical way to get through this in Donkey Kong Country.
Oh, this music again.
So everything changed to be Donkey Kong Country.
Oh, man.
And I was Diddy swimming around in a water level.
Yeah.
Except, I realized, oh shit, this level isn't normally flooded. It was the level with the lockjaw that was supposed to auto-kill you every time you were in water.
Oh god.
except now the whole level was water.
And it's just auto-kill.
So I had to trick shot myself around to, like, press the buttons in perfect timing to get past that portion of it where that fish was.
Yikes.
And went in a bunch of animal barrels and flew around and shit, and it was weird. I think I wound up at what was a zoo before it was flooded.
Uh-huh.
Which is a really shitty place to be in a flood. That's true. In an area where there could be plenty of dangerous animals about.
Yeah, like sharks.
Oh, come on! Can you get your phone?
Okay, you big baby. I'll grab it. Life stream, yes?
Yeah.
Alright. So I put in live stream and one of the results was live stream let it die. So apparently there's an item called Life Shroom in the game Let It Die.
Okay. That's not just a Lorax meme, is it?
No.
Okay.
Why?
Because that's the name of a Lorax meme, Let It Die.
That's the name of a game too, Let It Die.
Well, it could be either. Oh.
Let It Die is a game in which like a guy. Skeleton in a robe with like crazy ass like X-ray glasses calls you senpai.
Okay.
Hey, senpai. I can't find a life room. Can somebody tell me where to? East side of the main city. You can buy a life room.
East side.
Yeah, remember there's two shops.
In Paper Mario 2.
Yeah.
Not one, two.
West side, then.
I don't think there's only one shop in Rogueport.
No, there isn't. The booze.
Oh, you're right.
God damn it. I'm trying to get you accept the fact sometimes. Like,
well, you said east side.
Well, that's what they said. They're wrong. I'm like...
I was thinking of...
Left side.
Because I never think of that as a shop. I think of it as the front for the Italian mafia.
But it's an actual legitimate shop, too!
Yeah. Who knew? That would have sucked if we just didn't have access to buying one.
Nah. I would like to think that they kind of sort of thought of that.
I mean, not yet. Maybe it's in, like, the 7th area shop. Huzzah!
Yay, 50 coins in the hole. We better get our money back. The sexy moves.
Apparently, if you set high scores in the Pianta Parlor games, the kitty boo behind the desk will, like, tell you more and more details about herself.
She's trying to hit on you!
Reluctantly.
Reluctantly telling
you. So I guess either she's a tsundere or we're supposed to assume that Mario's trying to hit on her.
Hey, I'm Luigi. I'm the richest man in Mushroom Kingdom.
Hey, Mario, there's a boo tried to come on to me the other day. You know what that's about?
No, Luigi. By the way, I maxed out your credit card. Sorry. Why are you coming back here?
Because we gotta deliver the life shroom.
Oh.
She wanted it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's why she's like, she's afraid of dying.
Okay.
Oh, hey, 10 coin profit.
Your Amazon pantry delivery is here. You old bitch.
That was a great voice. That was quite a Mario voice, but it was a great voice.
I gotta stop trying to do Brooklyn Mario. I can't do Brooklyn Mario.
Luigi.
Okay, back to the Trouble Center.
Bowser's minions have flooded the underground.
And they're still kind of useless.
Did you try aiming where he was going to be? Oh, I didn't think of that! You gotta give him some lead.
I've been watching videos of Snipper Clips. Have you seen that?
No.
It's apparently a game that is like an indie. I don't know if it's indie. It's a launch title that you can get on the Switch.
Oh, okay.
Zelda. And I think I'm more interested in it than I'm interested in Zelda.
Oh my god. What's it called?
Snipper Clips. It's like a little kind of party game. Okay. Jolene wants help.
Need some motivational speakers.
Let's save that.
Okay.
I think I remember this one sucking. Let's get Frankie out of the way. I'm looking for something.
I can't tell you what it is.
West side of Roadport. Hi-ho, Yoshi!
Okay. Yeah, that's right. Because I guess we're facing northward.
Yeah. West side, east side.
West's broadside.
What was that comic strip? The Far Side, that was it. Frankie? Frankie? Maybe he's in the parlor. Nope. Hey, what's up? Okay.
Oh, you don't actually, okay. Well then.
They're 18, by the way.
Oh, are they?
Yeah.
Who are 18?
The booze.
I don't think it matters, they're dead.
No, I'm just saying they tell us that.
Oh, is that what they say? They actually say that, huh?
Yeah.
So wait.
Where the fuck is Frankie? Frankie!
Hey, Frankie!
Oh, where the brother's at? I'm glad it's someone tight-lipped, that's all. I lost my wedding ring.
Again?!
God damn it, Frankie. It's on the east side, you know somewhere.
You know exactly where it is?
We'll do some looking around.
Okay.
Can't be that bad.
Oh no, it's... I'll say this is gonna take you an hour.
How big do you think this map is?
I'm not concerned about that. There we go. Thank you for proving me wrong. I've never been more happy to be wrong in my life.
Yeah. That's what I love to do. Holly ho!
The chest just disappeared.
Oh yeah, it's just
fell to the ground.
Well,
you opened
a litter,
and then like some enterprising individuals just took it for scrap.
Yeah. Good lumber is hard to come by.
Yeah, we got
the tube mode game. You think the games would like, as you unlock the higher ones, you get a better profit margin? But no, the first one you unlock is the best one for making money.
I guess, or not like actual money, but you can't ever cash out, right?
You can buy gold bars, remember?
Oh yeah, that's right.
Or exchange for them.
We could probably do that. It'd probably be quicker to just buy some gold bars, sell them, and then get the badges we need.
No, you actually can only get the badges, the badge here, so.
Oh, no, I meant the Wario stuff.
Eh, we'll get it.
Power Rush.
Yes.
It's like breaking the badges in this game is like the feeling you get when you break magic cards in Magic the Gathering.
Yeah.
Just like make totally busted combos. How many power brush?
All of them.
Berserker Mario.
Do like a danger partner build. Keep all our partners at 5 hit points.
Oh man, that would be risky.
Yeah.
Although it'd be interesting to try that with people like I guess.
I mean, they also have close call P, so you could do exactly the same strategy. It's just
Yoshi doing that like 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
You just have to maintain the their hit points because you can't go to like inns or use heal blocks or anything.
Oh, yeah.
So it'd get expensive on the items.
They don't get partners that are affected by that doesn't make any sense. How many are gold bars?
I think it was like 200 something.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, 234.
And that's three of them. Well, let's get this shit going. You gotta ship this build off.
Obviously. Okay, those are still good. Oh, we don't need power plus P that badly.
I guess not with this coming up. 5 left! All your powers are now mine! What's Mega Rush do?
That's if you're in peril.
Okay, never mind.
Oh, right, we got another pretty lucky, too.
Yeah.
Happy Heart's nice to have.
It's probably still needs Spike Shield.
What can I get rid of with?
I didn't get rid of Jumpman. Because you can't use your hammer right now because of Jumpman.
What?
You can't use your hammer right now because of Jumpman.
Oh, that's alright. I don't need my hammer. There we go.
Okay. Sounds good.
You know, we might be able to get through the Pit 100 trials now, but let's not. That's going to be its own stream.
Yeah. At least get the combat to show it off.
Yeah. We'll get there. Let's see what the next job is. I guess you want to go to the Glitz Pit now?
Yeah, sure.
Let's just annihilate the Glitz Pit. Let's shred everything.
I'm Danger Mario. Mario, like, Great Gonzalez leaves, like, his terrible gimmick behind and then, reappears, and his new gimmick is that he's Danger Mario.
Yeah,
he's like Mario, except he does, like, dangerous spots, like balcony dives and shit.
He comes back up from the edge of death.
Reminds me,
There's a wrestler in Japan called Dinosaur Takuma.
Yeah?
It's like, it's all caps!
Okay.
And I'm like, look at that going.
You think he could beat Dragon Dragon?
I don't know. I'll have to just watch and find out.
No. Fuck off. Was this where I wanted to go? No, it wasn't. Shit.
No, this is a pit of 100 trials. You don't want to be down there.
Well, fuck it. I know a shortcut to the end, to the top. What do you guys think about a Paper Luigi game? What are you talking about? What do you think we're playing?
We're actually just going in there now. Fuck it.
This is faster than... This is multitasking. It gets us back to the surface while also taking care of this.
It's faster. Speedrun strats.
I don't know. I'd be down for Paper Luigi if it meant we got back to this battle system and not the other Paper Mario gimmicks that have been happening.
Paper Luigi's all about getting as many people as you can between you and your enemy.
All the coin amounts are multiplied like by 100 in Paper Luigi.
Yeah, there's like a war economy. You like recruit as many people as you can. Dude, Paper Luigi would be like a tactics game.
Final Fantasy meets Paper Mario. Not Final. Fire Emblem meets Paper Mario.
Oh god, Luigi's just using his mass amounts of wealth to like hire as many people.
And charisma. Don't forget about charisma.
I guess he's got that. Like, maybe. Don't all his partners like hate him or something?
Mario!
I always figured Luigi is more of a tactician type.
Yeah.
Huh. Like, Earth, moon, huh?
If what this map indicates is true, the location of the final crystal star is the moon!
We're going to the moon!
This loon?
Seems suspicious, huh?
How does one get to the moon?
You strap yourself into a fucking rocket and you just kinda...
Please excuse me.
Come back in a little bit. Come back later is our answer.
I'm trying to figure this shit out, but oh, I guess he figured it out.
Nah, that was just, that was probably like a Rogueport newsletter.
Oh, damn. Alright. We're not reading a whole lot of the lore. But it's fine.
Well, you want to go through our... Go through our email?
No. I said no, and you're like, fuck it.
You're the best, man! I hear you uncovered my imposter!
What the fuck is it with identity theft in this episode?
I'm headed to Toontown to fill my next leading role! I'll leave you the line from my latest movie. Best of luck, kid!
Oh, him. Oh, yeah! The Johnny Cage motherfucker. Well, I guess there was, like, identity theft in that portion.
Oh, yeah. So now, three
cases. This is identity theft a recurring theme in this game.
Three cases of identity theft in this episode, this stream.
Wait, I thought you were going to Blitzpit.
I am. Okay. I took a wrong turn into the pit of 100 trials.
Yeah.
Went into a bad neighborhood. Okay, so I don't want to go down the pipe. There we go. It's a goal. Wee. Hey, look, Mario, I got my own game. It's a gameplay. They just don't even attack. They're just watching.
That's impressive. How's he able to do that?
I like Oh, God. Okay. I have a solution to this. I like how in the glitz pit, there was, when you went through the sewer, there were people in the locker room just turning and like, what the hell is that? What's going on? And I wish that enemies would do that when you, like, floated by as a boat. They just turn and...
This question mark, huh?
Yeah. Oh, damn it. Okay, I thought I had the first strike badge. I guess I don't.
First strike badge?
Yeah, it lets you kill enemies in the field with a first strike.
Well, alas. Weren't you going to show off your new build anyway?
Yeah. You know.
Oh! They can't move past that point!
No. I can still do it in the field.
30 damage! Holy fuck!
Did I fail the action command? I think that's what happened.
You failed the action command! 30 damage! 31! 31!
This is the power of Paper Luigi!
Training from hell.
Oh, I did it the wrong way.
It's fine.
Ooh.
Better get your mouse chick. One damage.
Oh no.
Happy Heart's not really kicking in.
Well, we keep winning on the first turn, so it doesn't have any time to.
Fair enough.
Yes. Here.
What? Oh.
Since you mentioned it, this poor thing is giving it his all.
Yeah.
He's trying. Come on! I still have it equipped. I didn't take it off.
No, I don't think he did.
Yeah, keep trying. The little train that could. There we go.
I guess that's a strategy, just heal.
Against weak little no-damage enemies.
Yeah. Dude, you're pretty lucky!
Now I'm gonna be even harder to hit.
62 damage, man!
See, I could grind for more of the close call badges on... I think Goombas carry them, but... I'm not gonna do that on camera, and I guess it's whether I decide that 2 is enough or not.
Alright, let's see if you can get it this time. There you go. Oh wow, the damage for the other 3!
Yeah. Yeah, I guess it doesn't increase that damage. The other ones got it off. The first one got the full brunt of it.
He's massacring us! Get all the coins, by the way.
I don't want to get hurt, though.
You're not gonna get hurt. They're gonna attack you, and you're.
Come here.
Holy shit! Kick his ass already.
But I want to do it in one turn. I want to be fancy.
Multi-bounce.
I like how the one that got the most damage gets to live just a little bit longer.
Yes.
It's like we decapitated him and his head's still alive.
Yeah, I guess for a little bit. So I was reading about this game, Middle Earth, Shadows of Mordor.
Just cause I can. Yes.
And apparently they have a system called like the Nemesis system. It's like enemies that you kill sometimes won't die, and they're like named and they got personality traits and stuff.
Yeah.
And then sometimes you like fight them, and if he's giving you trouble, you can kill him. And then unless you kill him like really super dead, he'll just come back, and then he'll be like, "You tried to kill me, but now I'm back." It'll wreck your shit.
Oh, okay.
I thought that mechanic was very interesting. Like, imagine that, but with Mario games. Like, there's certain enemies that are, like, named.
Like, there's just a Koopa you can run into in a group of a bunch of Koopas.
Yeah, and he's like, it's not just Koopa, it's the Koopa.
And if you don't deal, like, 50 damage to him in that battle, he'll come back later stronger. He'll be Can't See Koopa.
Yeah, he'll come back with scars and just be like, you ruined my good looks, now I'll have to kill you. But yeah, you can get rid of those kinds of enemies in that game by decapitating them, so...
Makers of Epic Paper Mario, we hope you're listening.
Yeah, implement the Nemesis system.
They scattered a lot of those Ultra Boot things around the game. Annoyingly so.
Well, because I love a game that encourages, like, backtracking.
Encourages? You mean forces?
Yeah.
I mean, it can be okay in certain cases, but... If you're only going... It's better if you're going back for multiple things. If you have, like, a checklist of things to go back for.
Yeah.
Not you have to go back this big long distance just for this one tiddly little item that they chose to hide there.
Yeah, that's not good.
Oh, why isn't there a pipe that goes to Glitzville?
Because it's in the sky.
You don't bring your logic into this. Bowser figured it out.
Bowser's an idiot. The logic doesn't apply to him.
Okay. In fact, I thought I put two happy hearts on. They did take a long time to activate, if that's the case.
They're just unlucky, maybe. Like, with three, you were averaging out about one every turn, so...
Even luckier!
Sometimes attacks won't hit you.
And the third one.
Just out of range! That's fun! And hello. You got rid of all your fucking posters.
Champion! Former champion! Why'd you give up the belt? Hello, Toad adoring fans. Have you really quit fighting, Great Mustard?
No.
Oh, that's sad.
I'm thinking I'm back.
You're the ex-champ, right? Yeah, Greg Gonzalez. Miss Jolene's the fight promoter now. If you have business, go down to the promoter's office. Are you planning your comeback? Because that would be awesome!
That is so awesome!
The right. Help is so enthused.
Yes, the help! The help! I don't like that term for some reason. Just
the security.
The help.
It is a very snobbish rich person term.
Yeah.
Like, I guess you'd want to be a fan of the fights if you were working here.
Yeah. It's like, I don't like the fights. I just keep people in line. Hey, Jolene. I'm thinking I'm back.
Our friend Rockhawk made a dramatic comeback and is reigning supreme again. They're so excited. Yeah, this is my new shtick. My new attire.
Yeah. I'm Danger Mario.
The green torpedo. All our records seem to be gone. What if they weren't gone? Do we just come back and we're suddenly champion again?
We just suddenly come back, grab a microphone and go, and just call him out in the middle of the ring?
Yeah, just in the middle of a Rockhawk fight.
Yeah, just interfere on the other opponent's behalf and say, that's a message! I'm coming for you, Rockhawk!
Oh, by the way, I'm also here for your,
Oh, is that why you're also here? Oh, I'm also here to finish your request.
Well,
oh,
I
really?
Wasn't actually... I didn't actually have any plans of a coming back, but since you flattered me...
I'll clear out your...
I'll clear out your trash in this room and in the ring, brother!
That's great!
No! I got it! I got it! If Luigi was here, he'd be the fucking Rainmaker.
Yeah?
Like, he'd be coming into the ring, and then, like, coins with his face on it would be falling from the sky.
And they'd be chocolate coins for the kids.
Kazuchika Okada, but as Luigi. Luigi's just wearing a fucking, like, green robe. This is fucking all this shit.
Jolene has a problem with worn trunks, apparently.
I did it. Can I get back into the fights?
Oh no! You don't still have it on you, do you? I know of a Goomba.
Oh boyfriend. No!
He's a fixer.
Oh, why? We have to go all the way back?
Yeah, this isn't a pleasant job. But
can we just fight?
Yeah, let's just fight. We'll multitask. Is this? I think ours was on the other side.
Danger Mario now comes to the, like, goes in the ring with a bunch of garbage into, like, a cart.
The
like
trash
Raven.
Man.
Like Raven. He's just a garbage can. He just smashes people over the head with it.
And then I eat the garbage. Is there actually a trash man in New Japan Pro Wrestling?
No. Shit. There was a guy who wrestled in, like, WWE and ECW called Raven. And he, like, came into the ring with, like, just a giant, like, shopping cart filled with a bunch of shit he could use as a weapon.
Oh, okay.
But not weapons.
I thought you meant, like, literal bags of garbage.
Nah, well, it was, like, stuff like a stop sign, like, a potted plant.
Yeah.
Just random-ass shit he would use.
Oh, no, not the Goomba Brothers. Oh, fuck.
Wait, what?
Don't attack at all.
Wait, how are we... Oh!
Yeah, like, Mario can't attack. The partners can't.
Okay, well, that's fine. Oh, so the requests get harder this time.
I'll use my other green torpedo. Now they're basically the same.
Oh. But we never got, like, don't attack at all last time.
I thought we did. It's always in the pool. So if we didn't get it, then we just got lucky.
Okay, we can do this.
We're bros! If we combine our strength, we'll ruin anybody!
Yeah, all five of you.
In 19th place.
Alright, Stephanie McMahon, I'll stay out of it.
This is how far the power of friendship gets you.
Three's not bad. Well, that was easy. There's gonna be a bunch of squash matches going up.
Yeah. You didn't even taste my power.
It reminds me in WWE, there was like a tag team. It was a...
Try to pump them up more. Don't just make an utter stomp, please. What's the tag team?
There was a guy called Sylvester Turkai, and he was accompanied by a hype man, Elijah Burke. And how it works is like Elijah would be in the ring, just like, for all the way from Big Bear, California, it's Sylvester Turkai. And then one time... Like, Turkai entered the ring with his hype man, and then Turkai's like, nah, I'll let you do it, hype man. And he's like, okay, and he wrestled, and they beat his opponent.
Yeah.
Those gimmicks were fine. It's a shame that Turkai didn't last long. Burke lasted longer than him. Which is kind of funny, considering he started off as a hype man.
Yeah. Oh, now we're known as the Superstar Sequel. Also known as the only good sequel. Buzzing.
Don't use special moves, huh? Is it oh no, star power.
You're trash! Come back when you learn to fight!
Guy, full on Kenpachi, just... He beat us like we were nothing!
We were nothing! To him, we were nothing.
The rest of this game's gonna be easy as shit.
Yeah.
5 hit points doesn't mean jack shit when you're dealing 30 damage every hit.
I think we should take on the Pitawan 100 Trials next stream.
Can we? Sure. Well, that's the bonus boss. Okay, yeah, we can do it. Because otherwise, we'll just beat the final boss, we'll come back to that, and then it'll just kind of peter out.
Yeah.
Like it did last time we played. It was just kind of like, oh, that's it. It's over.
I don't... Okay. It'll tell me what the condition was. I wasn't actually reading.
Oh, hey. What is it the guy say?
Yeah, nothing new.
Oh. What was the condition?
It'll tell us.
Oh, yeah. Don't jump.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, you fucked up.
Nah, we're fine.
I told you it'd be a problem!
Hype Man, you got this.
I mean, technically they're called managers, but basically they fulfill the role of a Hype Man.
Oh, no Hype Man!
Lucky! Whoops!
Coops is not so lucky. I decapitated them. Except I removed everything below the neck.
You ever do a Houdini on a man who is still alive? There's something deeply wrong with you, Joffrey. Alright.
Go ahead and get my points back.
Oh, yeah, that's right, you get cash from this.
Very small
amounts
at a time.
Much better than gambling at the parlor and getting gold bars, I guess.
Or going to across the fucking world to spend to get a 2-coin profit.
Yeah. Running a shitty imports-exports business. Next opponent will be Dead Bones.
Don't avoid switching partners out. What are you teaching kids about loyalty, always swapping your partners out? Okay, I just won't let my partner do anything. How's that for loyal?
He's so sweet.
It's like Mario's Goku and the partners are all the other DBZ characters.
All of them. Only useful situationally, like Krillin. Dude.
Hey Piccolo, none of us have an attack that can drill things. Can you like poke a hole in this dude or something?
I still want to see, like a fanfic in which Krillin actually took out Frieza with his fucking disc.
Yeah.
Just...
That'd be cool.
I got him, guys! I did it!
Vegeta just like, the fuck?
Oh, shit. Now I gotta deal with him.
Woohoo! I'm immortal, bitch!
I got him! I got him, guys! Meanwhile, Frieza's just, like, hovering. He's just like, oh, fuck.
So you get beat by a monkey. How's it feel to get beat by a human?
Might as well just kill yourself. His father later picks him up from space. He's like, man, did that Saiyan do this to you? No, it was that human! Wow, that's embarrassing.
I'm not even angry.
I'm just sad.
Let's not go for revenge on Earth. That would just be embarrassing for everyone involved.
This never happened.
We never tell anyone about the time Frieza lost to Krillin.
No, we'll say Goku beat you.
People will buy that.
But Dad, he's a Saiyan monkey!
Yes. Yeah, but...
At least he's not bald.
You remember that subordinate who shaved his head? What was his name? Nappa?
Oh,
he was funny.
I liked him.
I know I kept him around for a reason.
Don't attack for the first 3 turns. I wonder if that includes your partner.
It probably does.
Yeah. We'll be safe.
You're pretty lucky.
Oh, he's got a super shroom.
Oh, it's fine. If we don't attack, there's no way he can use it.
Coops the tank.
Nice. Lucky!
It went right on top of me and did nothing. That is lucky.
Nice.
Making them sweat! This is gonna give the audience members a show. They're just thinking, what the fuck's he doing? This is obvious.
That'll put butts in their seats.
He's obviously just fucking around.
Has it been three turns?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh wow, that guy can withstand it. That's awesome!
Yeah. No effect. That's impressive. Yeah, put him to sleep when he's like that.
Okay, it takes him the whole turn to do that. Well, no. I was considering robbing him, but I don't know if Ms. Mouse can rob him. Or if she'll, like, hurt herself.
Oh, probably. It's not like an attack.
If she tries it on, like, a pokey, she does hurt herself.
Wow, that's weird.
So any enemy that damages from the front.
From the front?
Yeah.
That's
or
from
has
the top.
Contact damage.
Oh. I mean, there's jumping contact damage versus sideways contact damage.
Right, and I don't think Spinies would be sideways. I just wasn't sure. The mind bogglers. God, no jump again? The crowd's getting sick of seeing you bounce around like a demented pogo freak.
What the fuck? Just imagine fighting somebody like Ricochet or Will Ospreay and telling him, oh, you can't use any high-flying moves.
But, I'm a jumper man.
I'm a cruiserweight. What the fuck you expect me to do?
Oh, I'm insulted.
God.
You think I'm a pogo freak?
God, fucking, this promotion's run by Vince McMahon.
Well, Coops, I guess it's up to you.
We're gonna have to brawl, I guess.
I'll just stand in front and tank with my super luck.
Can't you just use your hammer?
No.
Oh, but you can't jump. But you can use your hammer.
No.
Wait, why not?
Jump, man.
You idiot.
I think I'll remove that after this.
Yeah, please do. It's not like the damage boost from it is gonna... Or you can just use special.
Yeah, I could. Should I?
Whatever you want, man.
Oh, right, I got new specials. Yeah, fuck it, Showstopper. That's new.
What's that one do?
Insta-death.
Nice.
Boom, and... boom, boom.
God, you're ripping holes in space-time! Stop it!
I can afford to. I'm Luigi, motherfucker!
Only costs two!
Yep. So
what did he do? People in the crowd is wondering, the fuck did he just do?
So it costs the same amount as the earthquake.
And is strictly better.
Well, it doesn't work on all enemies. No, if it works.
Of course, but...
Now the weaker the enemy relative to you, the better its likelihood.
Now remove Jumpman.
If I must.
It fucked you over last time. You had to burn through flower, like, star points. You can't recover those immediately. Oh, you can have two back. Which means... No, that's all the power rushes.
Is it up there? Okay, I passed it.
So you probably don't need P up, D down.
I don't need it, but... Yeah, you're right.
Look at all those power rushes.
I know, but more power, man! I'll just be Majin Buu again.
Yeah. Well, it's like, you got 5 hit points. If you recover, then...
The punk rocks! No hammer.
No hammer. Oh, God! We just accommodated that, you... Ah! Okay, I guess you want us to do high-flying moves now!
This promoter knows her business. Oh, so now I'm not a pogo freak, am I?
Plans change! You're going over WrestleMania, sorry!
Look, Mario, some things were said. The Green Torture Squad.
So, I have an update on the Roman Reigns situation.
What was the Roman Reigns situation?
So last night, like, Roman Reigns reappeared, and is like,
this New Japan?
No, this is WWE again. And he's like...
Oh,
like,
right, he was the guy that people hated because he replaced The Undertaker, right?
He, like, beat The Undertaker, and he sucks in the ring and, like, everything. So... So then, people were like, so he was like sitting down in an interview, and he's like, yeah, retiring The Undertaker was the hardest thing I had to do, but this is my yard now. Then this other, like, big, giant, muscle-bound freak called Braun Strowman attacked him, and then the crowd burst out into cheers as he was, like, delivering this gigantic beatdown. Just like, yeah, Braun, go!
Beating up Roman.
Yeah, and then later on, they're, like, trying to sell, and Roman's like, oh, no, he's actually hurt. And as he's getting, like, stretched, like put in the stretcher, the crowd, like, was going, you deserve it! You deserve it!
The hate is real.
Yeah, and then,
wrap this up in 5 turns or less. I think I can do that.
Yeah, I think that's definitely possible. So, it didn't end there. So, as he was getting stretchered in, Braun came back and started attacking him. The crowd cheered even harder. Like, yeah! And then Braun just took him and threw him off a ledge while he was still stretchered in. And then they're like, crowd's like, yeah! Yeah! So then cuts. And it goes back, and he's being loaded into an ambulance. And then Braun goes, I'm not finished with you! And then attacks him some more. And then the crowd is at this point just like going nuclear for him. You know what he did?
What?
So he shut the ambulance. He went to the side of the ambulance.
And he pushed it over?
Yes! He lifted it up and pushed it over. The crowd was going apeshit.
So was that all part of the plan? They wanted to get so much hatred for a wrestler that they could just turn around and do that?
And get this other guy over? That would be brilliant, but I don't think so. I think they're still trying to, like, hey, let's feel bad for him. He got attacked from behind.
Yeah.
But this is wrestling. The crowd doesn't give a fuck if something's fair. The guy is hated enough. Anything goes.
Haven't seen that level of irrational hatred since the Nintendo Switch. People have a vendetta against that thing right now.
The Nintendo Switch is the Roman Reigns of gaming.
For some reason, people just have to prove how much they hate the Nintendo Switch. No items. Oh, okay.
This is this point where it's like there's like a bunch of Nintendo guys who are like just fanboying and like lobbying behind it and like, yeah, the Switch is the best thing ever, and they got people who are like, nuh-uh, I hate the Switch, fuck it.
I haven't heard any best thing ever fanboys. I've just heard, you know, some people, hey, they kinda like it. And then there's people who just are swearing up and down, it's garbage, it's trash, you're an idiot if you buy it, you fucking loser.
I'm a loser. Let people buy whatever they want. I'm trying to shame people into, like...
Yeah, if you don't like it, don't buy it. It's that simple.
It's not gonna kill gaming.
I
might kill Nintendo, but it's not gonna kill gaming.
Why, you think there's something wrong with it?
I don't know. If people don't buy it, then that's... Then people don't buy it.
Yeah.
At a certain point, it doesn't matter how good a product is. It just matters, are people buying it? Yeah. No? Well, shit. I mean... Pokemon's gonna keep them like afloat forever.
No, I just don't know if it's from like people feel threatened by it or where this hate spawned from.
I don't know. Like, I try not to get involved in that kind of politicking. It's dumb.
Please don't
allow us to like not use our partner for this fight.
Not attack for the first.
Oh god damn it!
I would hope that they disable that for this one.
What, first? Oh, the don't use your partner?
Yeah, that you can't get that condition. Because, yes, that would be unwinnable. Even Danger Mario can't penetrate these defenses. You know what? You're the first enemies I've faced who could survive an attack from me.
No, the other guy did. He had that one spiny that was, like, curled up.
Oh, yeah, him
He managed to no-sell your attack.
One Punch Man is finally satisfied.
So it's Mario versus the Gorillas of Destiny right now.
We've basically become One Punch Man. We can't not kill anything in one hit.
Well, I'm pretty sure some bosses would like, be okay, but... Hope you get lucky. Lucky!
For now. Mind you, I only grinded so much. We could get even more badges than this if we wanted
to. Oh, God. 100 damage per hit. Okay. I am the Dark Queen!
You can have a maximum of 99 badge points, and each of those badges only takes one to equip. So if you have 99 of them, that's... You get two per. 198 plus 201 damage for a jump.
Who needs any other badges?
So yes, you can... With a single jump, no action command, you can one-shot the strongest enemy in the game.
Oh my god.
Biggest boss.
5 turns or 3 turns?
3 turns.
Okay.
Ow.
Ow! Not as lucky.
Nope, less lucky.
Alright, let's do it. One shot!
We've gotten stronger.
Yeah.
What are you? You've gone nowhere.
You've remained the same.
You're stagnant.
I'm done playing around with you. Fucking why?
Alright, on to the major league.
Yep. How's the... I still wonder how the hell all the major league dudes are able to beat those guys.
Yeah, it's a question for the ages.
Maybe Rock Hawk tricked them into like attacking each other. Or maybe they just won by DQ. Hey, I'm back, guy, Undertaker.
I'm gonna beat you and then get the crowd's hatred.
And then Bowser's gonna come. Throw me in an ambulance and suplex the ambulance off a cliff, and then the crowd's gonna cheer for Bowser.
The tiny spinies. So what are these guys? Just a bunch of... Oh, it's those little red guys. How'd they beat the Harriers?
It's best not to think about it, I guess. Here we go! Oh. Yeah, this is gonna be good. Rock Hawk's gonna go down in one hit, right?
Oh yeah.
He has to.
I think these guys have the highest finite defense in the game. Doesn't matter.
25! So utterly dominant, just...
We're not even getting star points from any of these enemies anymore.
We're getting one.
Well, you had a minimum of one per fight. We're not getting any from the individual enemies.
That makes sense. Amazing Daisies will go, we go down really quickly.
Oh yeah. One shot. So we'd actually... Holy... If we do, we should do the Pit of 100 Trials one next stream. I've never done it before the final chapter. This is before even chapter 7. If we pull it off also, we're going to get so many fucking levels from the Amazing Daisies.
Oh my gosh. Mario's like, we can't just go to the moon unprepared. We got to prepare. So let's hit the Glitch Pit again, go down the Pit of 100 Trials, then we'll be ready for anything.
It'll basically come down to whether I fuck up an action command on the last 10 floors.
God. Or, you know, you don't get lucky.
Like, if I miss... No, I'm gonna take every group of enemies out with, like, one multi-bounce. But if I miss one multi-bounce in the last 10 floors, and I don't get lucky, then they could, one-shot us.
Yeah.
The truest glass cannon. But it's a very dodgy glass cannon.
It's a glass rail gun. It's like, what if Rey Mysterio was, like, dominant?
Can you imagine?
Like, as dominant as any big guy.
Can you imagine a glass racer in F-Zero?
Like
he's faster than everyone else, but
if he collides with the wall, he's done.
Yeah, one hit.
Fuck
one
me.
Hit point.
Oh man, that would suck. What happened?
Keep that alive. Okay, Coops, you're off duty. Yay!
How's that different from any other match?
You want my partner to do nothing, you say. Okay.
Oh, so you just want this to be over quickly, huh?
Gonzalez, I want a 5-second match. Can you do it?
Well, it'll be good to like build you up for the Rockhawk rematch.
So if One Punch Man were a wrestler, would he just be hated? Because it'd be boring, right?
Well, like if he could beat anybody with one punch, he'd make it challenging for himself by like, you know, just using grappling moves and stuff.
Yeah.
And there's been like a couple wrestlers. Roman Reigns is a wrestler that has invented his like signature move is just a Superman punch, just wings somebody. And Big Show in like his later years, when his back isn't doing so good, his finishing move is just he punches the dude's like lights out.
Yeah.
The difference is with Big Show is that he's a giant ass dude with like huge hands. So.
Yeah. What do you got for me? What next sad excuse for a challenge do you have?
The fuzz.
No flower points. Okay.
Oh, so just fight him. Just a straight up brawl, huh?
Who deals the most damage? I think Goombella. With her basic attack.
Yeah. You might want to focus on the most dangerous one. To you. The orc.
I can take out two of them.
Nasty Mjork.
Uh-oh. Yeah, you're not gonna use that, buddy.
Six damage.
He knocked his clock off! Literally!
Ha! Lucky dot, Matrix dodge, and then...
Paper Mario would be good at Matrix dodging, right?
Yeah. Somebody tries to, like, do, like, a kick above him, he just goes, like, down, like, that. Or, like, fireball!
Well, he's made of paper. He can just, like, sway around. I feel like that was in a, it wasn't in Monster Girl Quest. It was in some, like, fighting training game. Is that you're told, move like paper.
Oh, wait.
Oh, you're gonna make me do a special move?
Fuck, didn't they do that in One Piece? Like one of
I think
the
that is
like
it.
Dodging is like, oh, I'm paper now.
Paper craft, paper art or something?
Yeah.
That was one of the 9 techniques.
Yeah, the other was shave, which is like teleportation.
Yeah, that's where I'm
flash
step.
Of. Wizards! What's the gimmick?
I have to use a special move.
Oh, a star move?
Yeah.
Well, I better use break out the showstopper.
If I must.
Or no, that's a bit risky. You could also use the,
That's not gonna be enough to kill him.
Oh.
I get art attack, but that costs more.
Alright, showstopper then. Fine. Doesn't have to say we'd be successful with it.
We'll see. That was a hard one.
How much time you got for this?
I don't know.
Each of them? Seems like you don't really have to worry about it. There, oh no!
There is a time limit, so I try to not dawdle. You're nothing!
We're dealing. He's a demon!
Oh, you pussies using keto. Come back when you learn to wield a sword.
You say as you use keto.
I use my spirit pressure.
I use my spirit pressure to tear a hole in space-time.
Yeah, Boo did it. No hammer. The press is ruining me over kids bonking each other with sticks pretending to be you.
What?
I guess that's fair. I'm gonna take a nap.
Imagine somebody going up to Triple H and saying, you can't use the hammer because people are hitting each other over the head with hammers. Triple H would be like, so? We said don't try this at home.
We did our civil duty.
Hunter, you don't understand. The sponsors,
okay, bye, Goombella.
Sponsors are threatening to pull out.
Goombella's not gonna join us. She was stuck in the bed.
Okay. And, oh, him!
I don't even have to use a, like, flower points. Oh, there's only one of you? That's cute.
Alright, imagine this build versus the anti-guys.
We'd make short work of them.
Yeah, wouldn't be as threatening. When they appeared, we were just like, oh, fuck!
Oh, is that all, huh?
Like, remember when we purposely failed that fucking,
Yeah, yeah.
Then, now we'll send out three anti. Oh, shit!
We had no response for that.
Yeah.
It was a hard fight.
Yeah.
But no, against fucking Danger Mario, the only thing that, if you wanted to catch him off guard and really threaten him, it'd have to be like four Bowsers or something.
four of them just hanging out.
You have to face all the final bosses at once. Bowser, Cammy, Grotus, and the Shadow Queen.
Oh, God.
Appeal at least three times. God damn it.
So, Mario appeals, his partner appeals, you take a hit, his partner appeals, and then you finish with a multi-bounce.
Yeah.
Multi-bounce.
What were the bad guys? Oh, those three.
Oh no, they could actually probably kill you.
If they hit.
Yeah.
I guess, you know what I'm gonna do? I know what I'm gonna do.
What are you gonna do?
There we go.
Hedging your bets, huh? Fair enough.
Damn it.
Good thing you can heal.
Yeah!
Yeah, Luigi!
It's-a me! I mean, they're all Charles Martinet, so in theory, they can all do perfect, impressions of each other.
Yeah. Got 3 hit points healed! Great!
Woo! You tried.
Good effort.
You were more of a threat than anyone else.
Sure.
My opponent in that match was Jolene.
the screwy ass fight promoter.
Her battle conditions are the only threat to me.
This is the only way I can have a challenge. As if she limits me like this.
You got an eye patch, Jolene?
Here, do you give me a blindfold? I'll fight with no sight.
Remember when Yusuke had that dream about being blindfolded and handcuffed and he still kicked all those guys' asses?
Oh, really?
He's like, come on! Can't you? Do I have to tie my pinkies down or something?
do I have to be deaf to you? You gotta cut off my nose to eliminate my sense of smell. How'd you lose to the guy? He has no limbs!
Oh no, he had his... He said, like, do I have to tie my feet together, too?
Oh, what are we fighting?
Arf, arf, arf!
Oh, or it's literal, like...
They just fighting. Have lions.
Yeah. Send out the lions!
No items.
Oh, well, that's okay. Oh, they're still worth something!
Yeah, we finally got up to enemies that are worth something. Still... I just mauled a couple of dogs. They were probably Jolene's pets.
Yeah. Hey, could you beat my dog senseless?
Okay. They're ranked number 3.
They beat everybody else. Alright, now we gotta fight the Undertaker.
Yep. Fight, you say.
Well, I mean...
The Koopinator. No flower points. Okay.
Okay, so it's just hit him. Hey.
What's up?
I knew I would face you in the ring one day.
Again, you mean? You're strong. Oh my god.
The Razor Blade Brigadier. We'll see who's stronger. Yeah, we will.
Yeah, we'll see who's stronger. It should be decidedly obvious who's stronger.
If you're lucky, you might take two hits. No, just one.
Disappointing.
Mediocre. How did I lose so easily? He was so fast.
I didn't even see him attack.
I was looking at him, and next thing I knew, I was flying against the wall. It's weird.
You even fall slow. At least one special move. If I must, I think I could just art attack him to death.
Reality punch him to death, sure, do it, man. Can't you just use like a sweet treat and then just like fight him normally?
I could. Should I?
I don't know if you want to.
The feral nuclear reactor.
They got those in this universe?
I guess so. You know what I learned recently?
What?
You know how a hydrogen bomb works? A regular atom bomb is the trigger for a hydrogen bomb.
Oh my god, so... It's just a...
It's so bad that it takes an atomic bomb just to get it started.
Oh, that's scary.
He got up here even faster than his previous time, which was faster than how fast you got up here. We got to the championship in a matter of like 30 minutes. Someone said Jumpman in the crowd.
Yeah. That's great.
Who will emerge victorious this time? Rockhawk or Danger Mario?
Danger. Oh, is he new?
I don't know.
He's stronger.
I'm gonna see if I can take him out in one.
Alright.
I don't think so, but we'll see.
3, 2.
Nope.
Well, 2. 2.
Why are you so big?
Fuck 3!
Oh, wait. Wait! Oh, I'm sorry, Rockhawk. You wanted to move?
Ew. Down.
Punked out.
Squash match.
Oh. This is just sad.
Yeah.
An extreme battle of the highest caliber.
Yeah.
Fists and feathers of fury. I didn't see any feathers of fury.
Oh, the feathers that, like, came off of Rockhawk when you punched him in the snout.
Yeah, pretty much. So fast.
The most dominant champion the Glitz Pit has ever seen.
Is that the name of this stream, One Punch Mario? Yeah, we got the champs belt.
That and fraud.
You plan to move on, don't you? Of course, it's not like you're contractually obligated to, you know, stick around and defend your title for, you know, the crowds. No, you can go do whatever you want. Never fight again. We don't care.
You can be like Brock Lesnar. You can just be a champion that appears whenever he fucking wants to.
Oh, you know. I think I'm gonna retire. I have a win rate of 1 game, 0 losses. That's pretty good.
It's like a wrestler who, like, wrestles one match, wins it, and retires undefeated.
That was the guy in Space Jam did that, remember?
Oh, did he?
Yeah. What's his name? Bill Murray's character.
Yeah,
he played in that one game and then decided to retire.
Fucking Bill Murray shows up for that one scene, and then that's it.
Oh yes.
I'm basking in the glory.
The ladies love Luigi.
All right, I guess we should go finish our badge. We should probably finish the trouble.
Yeah.
Like the trash.
Take out the trash!
You know what's even more impressive? We were fighting all those battles just carrying a whole bunch of garbage.
Yeah. Literally garbage bags slung over our shoulder. Man, I can sure use a pipe. To rogue port. A pipe to rogue port, I mean.
Yeah. What happened? The champion came, destroyed everybody, took the belt, and then ran off.
We never saw him again.
The Glitz Pit then dies out as nobody's able to quite replicate the success of Mario.
We will never see a fighter like that again.
Then Link comes in and then revolutionizes hardcore wrestling.
Well, with weapons and shit?
Yeah. That ushers in the Attitude Era of the Glitz Pit.
Yeah. Where are we going? Oh, we have enough. Do you still got it, buddy?
Probably not. No, he does.
There we go. Hey, get Hammer Man! Only use Hammer!
Yeah, whatever. Alright. Should probably unequip the Luigi badge and equip that. So we can rip off another person's identity. Alright. We're
Wow.
Oh. I had to go. Have a rotten day. Have a rotten day.
Have a rotten day!
We gotta play that game at some point.
Yeah, we'll get to Wario.
Yeah, I didn't play that game at all. You showed me that game, and I was sold on it immediately.
Who did you want taken care of? Not who? What? Uh-oh, that's okay, too. They just made a murder joke.
Yeah. Those bottle trunks.
Battle trunks.
God. Throwing their fucking dirty ass tights in the...
No.
God damn it!
No, don't wash them, just burn them.
Yeah, burn the sheets.
How many fighters in the Glitz Pit even wore pants?
I don't know.
I think it was just Rockhawk.
It's all his? Wow. God, it's a good thing we kicked his ass.
We got some pretty decent bank from that.
Yeah. Pretty... Well, that was all the trouble stuff. Trouble center stuff, and then,
Well, I meant from the...
Oh, we gotta go back to the fucking Glitz Pit to tell her the job's done!
Yep.
God damn it! Yeah, let's go back to the Glitz Pit.
Well, Nintendo really wanted to make us hate this place.
Yeah!
And
the longest!
We're gonna be coming back here again next time, too.
Are we?
In the search for, General White.
Oh my god, I forgot that was a thing. Yay, we're flying! No, we're not.
Thank god this is skippable.
Yeah. Having to sit through that again and again and again.
Oh, my fans are gone.
Are the posters still up?
How do I grow a mustache?
Don't shave.
Hey, Jolene, I'm back with a new gimmick.
I'm the Rainmaker Mario. You do look like the... It's like
fucking got the same colors as fucking Okada.
Wow.
So Wario's pretty rich too. Yeah. He's like the second richest man in the Mushroom Kingdom.
He owns a company that makes micro games.
30 coins for all that walking.
You get more coins just going through the glitz pit again.
Yeah.
Glitz pit number one. Forever!
For how long now?
Forever!
Oh, okay.
Not confused, you mean like in a couple months? Forever! Okay, forever. I just found out, like, there's this guy in New Japan, Rocky Romero.
Yeah.
His, like, thing is that he gets two people on, like, opposite turnbuckles, like, just standing there. He just runs at both of them going, FOREVER! Just hits one of them, FOREVER! Hits another one, just keep doing it over and over again.
Okay.
It's really cool.
That sounds like a very specific move that takes a lot of preparation.
Welcome to pro wrestling. Alright. That's over with. You're going,
Got any other quickies?
Save all game progress? Yeah, sure. This game is the most violent Mario game.
Yeah.
With the fucking mugging that happens at the very beginning with, like, the mafia. I must have that book.
Fuck!
What? Oh, where's this one?
I lent a book to Miss Jolene. And now I need it back.
Oh no.
Please meet me in Poshley Heights.
What's this one? It sounds like you hate this one.
She lent it to Miss Jolene.
Oh. Which one is Jolene?
The one in the glitz pit.
Oh! Oh!
Oh.
Fuck me! We just can't escape that fucking place! Oh, you're here for a book. By the way, you wanna work a retirement match?
Wow, Gonzalez, we see you a lot these days. What's up?
You have a book? Oh, yes, that's right.
Can I just, like, get everything involved in every Trouble Center shit that you're involved with? You've made a lot of enemies, Jolene.
Don't understand. This is a nice neighborhood. We don't want your kind here, Wario, with your fat, like, belching and your money grubbing.
Just Wario.
Well, I don't mind the money grubbing part, but you're just a slob.
Wario buys a mansion in a really ritzy part of town, and all of his fancy neighbors hate him.
He throws, like, the loudest of frat boy parties, and everyone's just like, ugh. Him, that ruffian.
He has all the Mario parties at his house.
And you know, to be fair, there's no love lost. Wario goes out of his way to be as obnoxious as possible.
Yeah.
Just like, the fingers way up.
Asshole rich guy Wario.
Like, out assholing the other asshole rich guys.
Yeah.
And they're just looking at him going, but this is a nice neighborhood. You just fart in their face going, have a rotten day.
They have a garden party and he brings just raw garlic as hors d'oeuvres.
Who would invite him?
He'd invite himself.
Wait, who paid for the catering? Oh no! Did you really invite Wario over for tea? Maybe he's misunderstood. He pisses in the fucking kettle. Oh, my mistake.
Wario won the first Mario Party.
Wario knows how to party, dude! These fucking rich people don't know that! Oh.
I played, You saw I played Awesome Knots yesterday with some of the guys.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. We talked about a couple things. Apparently the Dolphin, the GameCube emulator, has netplay.
Oh, it does?
And some people have been using that for Mario Party.
Oh, that sounds fun. We're able to get it to work. That'd be fun.
Yeah. And they also said, Bacon said that apparently there's a group that is working on or has made a multiplayer Mario Sunshine.
How the fuck would that work?
I have no idea. But also according to Bacon, that same group is working on a multiplayer Paper Mario.
How the fuck would that work?
I don't know! I'd be interested to find out.
Yeah, that'd be interesting. Paper Mario together? That'd be great.
And Paper Wario is a character. I think Wario and Waluigi...
You have to hold down a button to charge up the fart.
I think Wario and Waluigi are both in Epic Paper Mario. But don't quote me on that.
I mean, they're conspicuously absent.
They might have... I don't remember if they were in any of the later, more recent Paper Mario games. Because I know that Sticker Star introduced Bowser Jr. And I think the Koopalings have appeared by now.
She wants it back now. Okay.
Don't get the wrong idea. I borrowed it as a promoter, that's all. It's not like I follow fads or a wrestling match.
Bro! Oh, it's a dirt sheet!
Just
like
full of
Dave Meltzer!
Just full of a bunch of half-naked, sweaty, muscular guys.
Nah, she's reading it for the five for like the star ratings, like, what? Why was this Great Gonzales match -5 stars?
She's looking for, she's recruiting.
Oh, who's in the top 500? Oh, this Bowser character seems like he'd be pretty cool.
Okay, so we have the Glitz Pit. What other wrestling organizations or fighting organizations are in the Marioverse?
Fuck.
Or would be?
I don't know, somebody doing MMA?
The Pit of 100 Trials is the underground organization.
Oh, the Fight Club.
Yeah.
It's the ECW. You just call it the Pit. Alright, now we're going back!
That Jackie Chan character who was the queen of wrestling, but she wasn't challenged enough, it was the guy. The Hulk Hogan parody. He wasn't challenged, so he went to the underground wrestling rings.
The underground!
You know, they pay more.
I always love that you got the official stuff, and it's like, oh, that's not enough, you gotta go where the real action is, the underground shit.
Yeah, the illegal stuff.
The Kimbo Slice dude.
Try to get a couple more.
I guess get a couple more. What time is it? It's almost 1.
I got until 1:30 at the latest. Right. So. We're gonna have at least a couple left over after we finish this chapter.
Are we going back to Koshly?
I don't.
Return the magazine?
Oh, we do have to do that, don't we?
Yeah. Before we can take on another Trouble Center request.
Can't we just take them on all at once?
No.
It saves so much legwork.
What do you think this is, Skyrim?
Get in there.
Oh,
On to Greenwich, Connecticut.
It's me, Wario!
Oh no!
He's back!
God damn it, I just had my lawn mowed.
Everyone, cover your grills! Cover your pools!
Oh my god. He bought a German Shepherd recently. He's gonna dirty the bloodline of my cute little dogs.
He's got a Rottweiler.
Your pool's got a shark in it, assholes!
That's their anti-Wario measure.
You don't understand. This is a nice neighborhood. Oh, platinum card. What does that do?
It's the boat mode game.
Oh. I guess rich people also like wrestling. That's cool.
Another game that's not as profitable as the plane game.
But you gotta unlock it anyway.
Hotel. Hotel Mario?
You don't really need to be in this section at all. There's no enemies, there's nothing to fight,
It's just the way to get to the pipe.
Yep. Man.
Can you imagine how the Ouran Host Club would react to Wario?
I don't know, I think they might like him. Yeah, they hang out with the fucking broke chick.
Yeah, he's the fat, disgusting type. We don't have one of those in the club.
the women who are inexplicably like attracted to Eric Cartman.
Yeah.
Like
that's what he's for.
Yeah, I guess so.
He has his niche.
Yeah, you could be the frat boy. Okay.
You know, they clean him up a little bit, give him like a sword, he has a Yajirobe cosplay.
Who has less class, Yajirobe or Wario?
Wario.
Yajirobe chills with cat gods. Wario just kinda is a degenerate.
Yajirobe's lazy. Wario goes out of his way to be disgusting. Which granted didn't used to be his thing. That was more since Smash Brothers and WarioWare that they decided to go that route with him.
Wario's the kind of guy who's like, he encounters like somebody's like, "You're a disgusting fat body!" He goes, "I'm gonna kick your ass."
Thank you!
Is he malicious, though?
He's just greedy.
After the first game he was in, he just kind of stopped being a dick. Well, he's still a dick, but He helped Mario out that one time.
He only targeted Mario
in
because he was
rich. In that remake of Super Mario 64.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, the other side.
That was only because he was promised cake, though.
Oh, really? Well, that's fair. Yay, you unlocked that.
Something.
What is that?
Eh.
No. That was unnecessary. You got hit points.
It's over here. Pretty sure we already went here a bit.
Yeah, it's the curse lady. By the way, it hasn't been happening a whole lot. We should probably refresh that.
I don't think we bought it.
We did, like, a while back. Remember, because then she would, like, show up and then say, oh yeah, the curse has increased her star points and shit.
Oh yeah, that happened a couple times.
Yeah. Happened quite a lot.
I kind of stopped noticing it.
Plus, because it ran out.
Yeah.
Who's handy to have?
Yeah.
I guess, like, when it happened. It worked pretty good.
If it works.
Alright, what's next?
Alright, let's see what this is.
T Tasty and Petalburg, huh? Alright.
Toasty.
Oh, toasty. Never mind. What was the chef in the first game?
That was Tasty.
Yeah.
And then this one is Zesty.
Zesty. The cranky woman. I won't let you go to the west side unless you fix my contact lens. Asshole.
Well, it's a good thing we relearned where she was. To Petalburg, ask Toasty all she knows.
I want to know how to bake a heartfelt cake.
We can come back.
I just bought it from the store!
We can come back if we have coins to spare, but we get a better return from the mouse guy.
Oh yeah, we need to do that.
So we'll if we max out him, we'll come back.
All right. Ow. Crap. Okay, that's good.
Danger Mario is Wario. He deals a lot of damage with his Herculean strength, but he's got just tired all the time. He's got really high cholesterol. His just body is full of shit.
Yeah. He's only interested if they promise a reward.
Okay, who's Toasty? Are you Toasty, shop owner? No, you're Nifty.
Remember when we went out of our way in Wario World to just not get 100% to see what the.
Oh right, yeah, we did that. We got like without collecting anything. Should we do that?
Anyway, you just got a cardboard box.
Should we beat the game that way and then go back and collect everything?
Maybe. Nah. It would bother me too much, I feel. You're Luigi's older brother! Yeah! Don't I look it?
Wah.
Luigi's older brother, Wario.
Cake mix, ruin powder. I wonder who she's making it for this time.
The fuck is ruin powder?
So, in the previous game, the Merlee was like the one who was lusted after by everyone. Now she's just like this lonely girl in the sewers giving cakes to all the guys.
Wow, times are tough.
All right, I got your recipe. But this isn't gonna be that easy. You're gonna ask me to make it, aren't you?
Could you make it for me, please? And thank you!
I have no cake mix.
Could you give me some cake mix, please? Fucking hell. Fuck you.
She's actually just gonna give it to Wario. Slash Mario. You're just an elaborate ruse to ask him on a date.
somebody went through all that much trouble for me, I couldn't say no.
Ah, you just heard I was rich!
Can I just...
Running!
I just want to go home and go to bed!
This is the only way to get cake mix, by the way, so thank God we had some extra
coins. We have to go to the fucking gambling parlor to get some cake mix. Hey, it's my son's birthday. Oh, crap. I gotta go to the casino.
Give me cake.
Wait, is that zero?
Six.
Oh, okay. Yay.
This poor Yoshi's giving it his all.
Yeah.
You know what? I think I'd be more interested in a Paper Wario than a Paper Luigi.
How would that work? It'd be the same thing. You just spend money to like get people to fight for him.
Everything would be themed around money. Well, Wario does his own fighting. He's like a treasure hunter for money.
Oh, so it's just Wario going to like to like plundering riches.
Yeah.
And like you do optional combat to
he'd be like
to,
every
like, get more money.
Every chapter would be just a different ancient dungeon he's raiding for loot.
Yeah, the coins go up to like the billions.
Yeah.
And then you can spend all your money on like frivolous shit to make your mansion look better.
Yeah.
It'd be great.
He's got partners. I guess Wario wouldn't use a hammer. He'd just use, like, fist attacks.
Yeah, fists and body slams.
And it'd be great with Wario because the action commands could also function as, like, a combat system. Like a 1-2 punch kind of thing.
Yeah. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. There's, like, one Wario game in which, like, Wario couldn't die, but like any like enemies just cause status effects that you didn't usually like get from point A to point B.
Yeah, the Wario Land games.
Yeah, that was weird. $30 for all that.
Okay, that wasn't as bad as I remembered, but it was kind of annoying.
Yeah, just can you give me some cake mix?
So if you spent the coins on the cake mix, it would have cost 18. So that's a 12 coin profit for all the footwork.
Jeez.
There's one more. There's one good one in here. I'm pretty happy living out here on Keel Hall Key, but there's one thing I miss. I need a girlfriend.
Oh my god! You want me to?
I'm in the storeroom, deep in the cave on Keel Hall Key.
Oh my god.
Why are you there? Do you live there?
You just, hey, nobody else is using it.
Hanging out in a pirate's den that's been abandoned.
Yeah, nobody else is using it! Alright, this should probably be the last one.
Yeah. And we'll save when we're done, and I might do a little bit of grinding off-screen just to get a couple more of those, like, close call badges.
Yeah. Just so you can, like, survive hits easier. Trying to go for, like, dodge build, not a blocking build.
Yeah. Although you can get enough, there's also enough of the, I think Goombas drop both the close call and the one that makes you take half damage when you're in danger. So you can stack enough of those that you only ever take one damage from any attack, too.
Makes sense.
God damn it.
It's fine, you can kill him.
I know.
Oh no, a threat. Maybe.
Hey, they give me one star point each. That's something.
Oh, isn't it something?
Oh, thank you.
Hey, happy plus. Oh. Bjork.
Elbow drop!
He's getting punked out. Oh, hey, we had 100 people in our crowd.
Oh, yeah. I don't know what the exact levels that you get upgraded your crowds are. Hey, buddy, just still hanging out here? That's cool. You keep doing what makes you happy.
Your Damn it. Aw, dang it. No threat. Alright, we're on the move.
It's at this point that Mario thinks to himself, I'm riding a Yoshi through a jungle I've been to 3 times to get a Goomba I don't know a girlfriend. What the fuck am I doing?
Somebody requested it and we were dumb enough to take on their request, so here we are.
Well, you know what? This gives an excuse to get that one fucking star, that shine sprite.
Yeah.
Never do anything unless you have 2 good reasons.
Oh, you're gonna use cold for that. I just stopped in your tracks like, oh shit,
I was trying to press the thing, the button. What's ice power is only 1. Eh.
Ow. Oh, that worked. Cool.
And they're back.
Yeah, I guess so. Why is he hiding out in this fucking cave?
You know what, though? He did. That means he had to fight his way past all these dudes. That's kind of impressive.
Wow, he's really going, like, all the way for his solitude.
For a Goomba.
Yeah.
Like, that's gotta be a tough Goomba.
Yeah. Tough Goomba.
Damn it.
Your poster.
And lucky. Bye!
Off-screen hit.
These bullets have to lead miserable existences.
Yeah!
Because they only live long enough to kill themselves.
The life of a drone.
Their lifespan is shorter than a housefly.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, they're still worth something.
2. 1 hit is enough to kill them.
So there's a point in the game that once you get...
Just kill the other one. Oh, no, wait, that was it.
Once you get to a certain level, and you're just getting no star points from anyone anymore... The only real way to grind is to just come here and just grind bullet bills forever.
I guess so.
Get 1 star point per battle.
Oh no, not you.
I was tempted to do the thing again, but I didn't do the thing.
No, because you're at 2 low hit points for it to be worth it.
Yeah, if it actually lands the attack on me, I'm done.
Job.
I remember you. Just every now and again, that trumpet comes in and interrupts the background music.
Yeah.
Da-da-da-da. It's very out of place.
Yeah.
Wow. Nope.
Not doing combat at all.
Put on the ice power badge. I haven't even fought any of the lava bubbles.
Well, I mean, it was a good strategy.
It's a good precaution.
Yeah. No, 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 no.
No, 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 no. No threat.
No.
Why are you here?
Yeah, Gumbella is like, what the fuck is the deal with this guy?
Hey, thanks for taking on my trouble. All the way out here, too. I know it's far. Fuck you. I came out to enjoy island life, but now that I'm here, I just feel lonely.
There's no one to date.
I mean, no one. I'm chatting up sea turtles.
Wow! He has to make do with the animals.
And Coop's like, wow! Offensive! I'm right here!
Introduce me to a nice girl.
Petite, younger than me, and pretty. Not drop dead hot. That's one attractive shell! But that makes you a Koopa. Not only that, but you're a dude. This is all wrong!
Wait, so to finish this, you need to just show him the right part. Oh,
introduce
my God.
Me to a cute Goomba gal. I'm dying over here! I'm not feeling attractive right now. Aww.
Just getting flurry. Hey, what about you, Flirt?
Whoa, now that is a very glamorous woman. But you're kind of old.
Oh, wow. That's.
And you're not even a Goomba. I never. Get your eyes checked. I'm a prize.
What about Vivian? What? Oh, Yoshi.
Hey, you're petite, just like I asked.
But you're a Yoshi.
Take a long waff off a short pier, you dork.
You're pretty.
You sure are cute, but that old goth shadow thing is a bit creepy. Aw.
You're not really doing much to impress. Wow, that's the sassiest Vivian ever got.
Do you think in the Japanese version...
Oh my God!
Do you think in the Japanese version the Goomba comments on the fact that she's actually a guy?
But, well, I don't know, maybe. Ow.
I found your soulmate! What's wrong with you? This is some crusty old dude! Oh, I thought it was
the
a short...
The side quest is really good.
I thought it was a shorter hit to this time. Well, you're hardly my type either, you young scallywag.
Oh, sorry. Oh, yeah!
What if he just says, you know what, I'll compromise here.
That's fine, whatever.
This is a cutie, but you're some sort of rat.
Wow, so this guy's just a racist.
He just only Goombas. I'd stay out of dark alleys for a little while if I were you.
I'll kill you next time I see you.
Alright, let's finish this. She's real cute. Slam dunk.
Oh my God.
I have to confess my love.
Oh no.
You believe in love at first sight, Angel? I love you. This is gonna go over about as well as our confessions in Artificial Academy. I'm going out with Mario. Wah!
I'm going out with Mario. Who's? Oh, Mario? Really? Why is he dressed like Wario?
Man, I've had enough of this. And then he just jumps in the water.
That would.
Peace. That was a weird.
Oh, what we get. Oh.
So, that Astafio you said about us. No, Mario, I was just trying to get him off my back.
I don't know, man.
Well,
you're human, that means you got a big dick, so.
Are you assured we can't, work something out here?
Mario, why are you talking like Wario? That's really creepy.
Oh God, I started the voice, I can't stop!
Oh no!
I
have a sudden urge to deface a rich dude's house.
You don't.
I want to throw a loud, obnoxious party that'll keep everybody up till 2 a.m.
We are Mario Brothers. We don't just put on a hat. We put on an identity.
If I become Waluigi, I'll be able to grant wishes.
Quack. All right, so that's it, right?
We're done.
I'll walk back off camera.
That was a fun stream.
Yeah. We got done with most of the Trouble Center stuff. We'd got the Glitz Pit done. We showed off Danger Mario. The game's going to be non-existent challenge
anymore.
It'll
just be us talking about irrelevant shit for the rest of the game.
Just like it has been up to now.
Yeah. Fair enough. See you later, everybody.
Yeah, see you next time.